talk about him today, and then we use him as an example of the consequences of not moving forward and always thinking about our past and carrying things with us. The person with the name, I'm not very good with this name, Ahitophel. Ahitophel. Those who are familiar with Ahitophel, he always comes in when you read about the story of Absalom and the rest. But this is not about Absalom. It's about himself. We all know that Ahitophel was a chief advisor, a counselor to King David. And then this man was doing well with King David. He was doing well, advising the whole king. Everything was fine with him. And they came, Absalom, trying to overthrow the dad and be the king. The first person who turned against the king was Ahitophel, the chief counselor. He was so trusted that if you think about it, a trusted counselor turning against you, why would you do this? But if you look back, I was just researching how could a trusted, according to Bible, if somebody say, if we say somebody is trusted, then that person is trusted. Trusted. So if the Bible can even say this man was trusted, a trusted counselor, then this man was indeed trusted. But if, and I was reading about it, this Ahitophel was a dad to Eliam. And Eliam is the father to Bathsheba. Now it's making sense, isn't it? And I was thinking, I want to read more. And then this Bathsheba that we're talking about is the one that King David had an affair with and killed the husband. So I was thinking, hey, maybe that's why. So what David did to Uriah and Bathsheba was years back. But this man, Ahitophel, couldn't even forgive David, even though he was a trusted counselor, a right-hand man. So in our life, that's how it is. Somebody will do something to you. I'm not saying King David was right, but we are we to judge if we can't forget about the past. That's what Hebrews was saying. We should strip off the weight. It's too heavy. It can cost you. It cost me 80 pounds, and then maybe it can cost you more. So we should strip off. When you read Mark 11:25, it says, Amplified Bible says, whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him. Forgive him. And then this is just the AA part. And it goes on to say, drop the issue. Let it go. Drop it, leave it, let it go. Am I making sense? Bible is telling you that drop it. Your situation was very bad years ago. Moving forward. That's why Apostle Paul says we should focus on what's ahead of us, not we should drop it. Leave it. And let it go. Leave it. Because if you don't leave it, I can even say, you do something to me, Mama. And I say, Mama, it's all right. I'm giving you. And the next morning, Mama will just break me and give me another. I say, oh, I'll pick it up then. So the Bible is telling us, just leave it. Not that, and let it go. Don't go back and pick it up. It's like a wound. The more you around it, the longer it takes to heal. Leave it. Let it go. Let it go. I know it's some of these cases when you hear about it, it's very difficult. Very difficult, but what else can you do? Ahithophel, a trusted counselor. And later on, when Absalom was killed, he went ahead and hanged himself because of bitterness, unforgiving. Drop it. Leave it all and let it go. Let it go. We are not living in the past. We are living now and through the future. So don't think about 27 years ago, Eric did something to me, I will never forgive him. 27 years ago was 1990s, late 1989. And then we are in 2016, and you're still holding that thing with the person. You're not hurting the person, you're hurting yourself anyway. You're hurting yourself. I don't know how myself, if I have some problem with someone, I can't even pray. So I don't know how people do it. And the Bible is telling us that when you stand praying, when you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, if anyone has something against you, just forgive the person, even before you pray. Drop it. Leave it and let it go. So how can a trusted counselor, maybe if it were our day, Ahithophel might be a professor or something like that. You go through all this stressful process of education and then the end because of bitterness, because of unforgiving. You lost your job once, you lost your life for nothing. For someone, something that somebody has done to your family for a long, long, long time. Long, long, long time. Long, long, long time. There's a lot of stories in our society that a mom and dad will leave nicely and something will happen, the dad will move on and then the mom will tell the children your dad was useless. And because of that, as they're growing up, that useless thing is in their mind. Most of them, they don't want to see the dad. They don't know the genesis of the story. The mommies, sometimes they don't tell the children, but the children will carry with them, my dad. I don't think I will give a penny to my dad, that man. But if you sit the person down and ask him, do you know your dad? Not that much. Not that much. So we should drop it. Leave it, especially if you want to pray. We always go on our knees and pray to God for so, so many things. The Bible is telling us from Mark 11 that we just read, that even before you go on your knees, before you stand up and open your mouth and pray, just leave it. Leave it. Let it go. be a free man so that you can communicate with your God. The Philippians 3:13 says, if you're there, you can read it for us. I think I've touched on it already, but we can still read it. And Philippians 3:13,
I'm reading from the NIV. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straightening toward what is ahead. Amen.
Amen. Amen. This is Apostle Paul. The gentleman who wrote almost half of the New Testament. He is telling us this. So we should forget about anything that lies behind us and focus on things before us. So it's very simple. It's the same, it's a bit similar to what Mark was saying in Mark 11:25. Just drop it. Leave it or don't go and pick it up. Stop opening your wound. The man is not there, don't talk about that man. That is one thing, it's very simple. If you want to forget about something, what do you do? If you want to forget about something, what do you do? Stop thinking about it and stop talking about it. The more you think about it, the more bitter you become. Very bitter. What did I do to this man to leave me with this kiss? And the funny thing is, that man is gone. You're still living with the children. These children are that man's inheritance. So anything that you say about that man, and then you're praying for these children, leave it all. Leave it, Gra. Leave it. It's a bit of weight itself. It's weighing us down. It's weighing us down. It's weighing us down. So don't poop around it and just focus on what is ahead of you. There's a story that I was reading about one president of the United States who was shot. That was in James, is it Crawford or something? And then this man was shot, and then, you know, as a US president, they will try everything for you to survive. And then they did it. This man survived, but they couldn't find the bullet. The bullet was hiding somewhere, I don't know. How can you shoot someone with a bullet in you? You're hiding. You couldn't find the bullet anywhere. Somebody tried to invent something that they can use it to find the bullet, they couldn't. So they keep on just, you know, looking around the body. And three months after that, this president died. Not from the gunshot, but from being around. They want to find out where the bullet is. But that man was fine with the bullet in. If you're not dead in the bullet, do you really mind about the bullet? But because they were just picture, they want to too inquisitive. And this man died. So the same with life. If you keep on going back, digging, there are so many things that we never understand. So many things. You can ask these questions over and over again. There are some questions that have been asked since I was born. The answers are not coming. So sometimes, don't bother yourself. Just focus on what is going on. And then your God will bless you. And then your God will lift you up. But the thing is, before God can lift you up, you have to drop this weight. It's weighing you down. You can see, honestly. It's like one time I was at work. Most of my shift, I do night shift. So, one guy that I worked with is from Nigeria. He's a big lad. And then when you get chance, it's not even in between breaks and after breaks. You just go down there. So if you don't snore, then you can sleep a bit. And this gentleman, as soon as he sat down, I said, my God, you can hear from. Me, I don't snore. I said, what? You don't snore. So sometimes there are some things that we do. We don't realize that we do it. Honestly. There are so many things that we do, we don't realize that we're doing it. Unless somebody comes to you and tell you that my brother is this so, and even that to fight with a person. So please, drop it all. Leave it. Let it go. Let it go. I don't know your experience, then, but my experience in UK is stressful enough for you to bring somebody's weight on top of it. Drop it. It doesn't worth a penny to carry on that heavy weight. If you go to Heathrow, you go to Birmingham International, they charge you about 800. So, please drop it. Drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it. Drop it. Don't talk about it. Don't talk about it. I know we got friends, sometimes something happens to us and then we bring them and then we pour our hearts. But if you're not very careful, that friend will not, if the person is not a believer, or even sometimes believers, if the Holy Spirit is not in the person, hey, the advice that you can get, you can even go and just kill someone. And then after that, was it me? Please. Please. This morning is very simple. It's weighing us down. It's weighing us down. I know it's very difficult. Very, very difficult. Some situation that we go in is very difficult. Sometimes, if you're not very careful, it will play in your mind, how can I forgive this gentleman? How can I forgive this lady? Trying to remember that, why this person did to me. Trying to remember. And if the Holy Spirit is not in the Eldaic will say, I remember. I remember this one, I'll deal with you. Leave it. It's like you carry someone's weight. The person will be fine anyway. But you carrying the weight for the person. Maybe the person even not aware. Instead of even going to the person and say, you know you did this to me. And maybe the problem would have been solved by then, but you're still keeping it. And one, if I were you, I can't even pray with that. Maybe I don't know how you do it. And then the Bible is saying that even before that, that means it's stopping you to pray anyway. You can't pray. You can't pray. So please, please. I know some of these things are very difficult. Very difficult. But the only place you can get these kinds of messages and advices is always from here, the house of the Lord. Amen. If you go to a counselor, you might be a trusted counselor. if he does it for free, you know what? You might even go and tell people all your problems. Please, drop it, leave it, and let it go. Shall we be on our feet?